Hi students, in this today's video we are going to learn about the plane of symmetry. Before watching this plane of symmetry, I have uploaded video on axis of symmetry. Please watch it for better understanding this plane of symmetry. It is represented by the symbol sigma. Now let's see the definition of this plane of symmetry. It is the imaginary plane that bisects the molecule in such a way that two parts are mirror images of each other. Here it is the imaginary plane, and it also bisects the molecule in such a way that two parts are mirror images of each other. See, by taking example we can see it. Take this water molecule as an example, and here is the imaginary plane. According to definition, we should pass imaginary plane that bisects the molecule into two equal halves. We are passing a imaginary plane here. Here you can see it is dividing the molecule into two equal halves. That means here oxygen also is broken like this. It is an imaginary plane. It bisects the molecule in such a way that two parts, we are obtaining two parts. It is the first part and it's the second part. These two halves are the mirror images of each other. This is the mirror image of this one, and this is the mirror image of this one. This is about the definition of plane of symmetry. We should pass an imaginary plane that should bisect the molecule in such a way that one is the mirror image of the other one. So next, here the reflection operation is carried out. Here the operation is reflection. See, it is the first one, and it is the example taken to explain the plane of symmetry. Now let's see, when the reflection operation is carried to this, here what happens, students? That means here is the oxygen, and here is the, let's differentiate it as HaHb, okay, to differentiate between two hydrogen atoms. So after the reflection operation carried, what will happen means this Hb will be this side. When the reflection means here H will come like this. Again the reflection operation is carried out. Again the reflection of this wall, what will happen, this Ha will come this side, and this Hb will look like that in the reflection. So here is the H and here is the Hb. These are just the reflection. This molecule's reflection will look like this, and this molecule's reflection will look like this. So it is a equivalent configuration. Means this is not same as the first one. We know that what is equivalent configuration. Watch our previous videos about group theory. I will drop the link of that videos in the description box. You can see that, and after seeing that you can watch this video to understand it better. It is a equivalent configuration. That means it is not same as the first one. It is the identical. That means these two are same. See, here is HA, here is HA, here is HB, here is the HP. But according to definition, this is enough to show how many reflections will give the identical configurations. I am drawing this. That's it. It is a identical configuration, and it is a equivalent configuration. It is not same as the first one. To differentiate, I have drawn it H and HP. Now see here, this sigma once, that means sigma once reflection carried out, means it will give this equivalent. Let's name it 1, 2, and 3. If once reflection is carried out, it will give second configuration. This is carried reflection one time, so equivalent configuration, that is the second configuration, is obtained. When the twice reflection, that means sigma square twice reflection, is carried out. Next, when the twice reflection is carried out, means this is carried reflection twice, so it will give third one. See here, sigma once reflection, it gives second configuration, whereas twice reflection, twice here's the first reflection and here's the second reflection, it gave the third one. See here, when the thrice reflection thrice reflection will again give second one. That means what happens means again this reflection will give this HA, HB this side and this A, HA like this. So again it will give the second configuration. That means we have understood that sigma n, where n is equals to odd, means either sigma is equals to sigma is odd, so it will give equivalent configuration. Equivalent configuration. Whereas when the in the sigma n, where n is equals to even, means it will give identical configuration. Identical configuration or original configuration. N is equals to even, it is giving third one. That means third is the identical configuration. When again this reflection is carried out for this configuration, again this HB will come this side and this HA will come this side. So it will give a equivalent configuration. Remember, always remember that sigma n, in the sigma n, if n is equals to odd means it will give equivalent configuration. When n is equals to even, it will give identical configuration. But here important thing is, just you should remember the definition and also example for this. Now let's see the classification of plane of symmetry. Classification of plane of symmetry. The first one is vertical plane of symmetry. Vertical plane of symmetry, it is sigma v. Whereas second one is dihedral plane of symmetry, it is sigma d. Whereas third one is horizontal plane of symmetry, it is sigma h. Now let's study one by one. First we can study vertical plane of symmetry, then horizontal, then dihedral plane of symmetry. This vertical plane of symmetry and horizontal plane of symmetry are easy to understand. Dihedral is similar as vertical plane of symmetry, but it is having some more complication. Now how these planes are classified means, these planes are classified depending on the relationship with the principal rotational axis or secondary C2 axes. We can write this definition, sorry, this point also. These planes are so categorized depending on their relationship with either principal rotational axis or secondary axis. Now each of the planes we can study it separately. First let's take vertical planes. Vertical plane of symmetry. First one is vertical plane of symmetry. It is represented by sigma v. Sigma v, here what is vertical plane of symmetry means, an imaginary line which is parallel to the principal axis is called as vertical plane of symmetry. We can write it. Imaginary plane which is parallel to the principal axis called as vertical plane of symmetry. It is parallel to principal axis. That means parallel means if here is the one line and here is the one line, these two lines will not touch each other in any way. It is the parallel. See, by taking example we can understand better. So let's take water as an example again. Here is the water molecule. So here is the z axis. Here z axis, which is a principal axis. Here C2 axis of symmetry is present here. Here it is the z axis. By default, principal axis is taken as z axis, and here is a C2 axis. That means here, by rotating the H2O molecule by 180 degree two times, we'll get a identical configuration. That means it is a C2 axis. Here is a principal axis and it is a z axis. Now, what is vertical plane of symmetry means? Imaginary line which is parallel to the principal axis. See, consider it as an H2O molecule. It is a H2O molecule, and these are the hydrogens. Here is the, this point is the z axis, like this z axis. Here is the z axis, and if you cut the molecule like this, that means parallel to the z axis. On this side, parallel to, here is, if you consider it as a z axis and parallel to the z axis, if you cut, means this off H2 will come on the front side and off H2 will come on the back side. That parallel axis bisects the molecule like this. Parallel axis bisecting the molecule like this. This off will come on the front side and this off will go on the back side. Here, if you take it as an H2O molecule, just for example, and if you pass a parallel axis, if you consider this as a z axis, that is C2 axis, if you cut the molecule like this, the plane of symmetry of H2 will come on the back side and of H2 will come on the front side. This is one of the plane of vertical plane of symmetry in the H2O molecule. Like this, it will make the of H2O on the front side and of H2O molecule on the back side. I hope you have imagined this. This is the vertical plane of symmetry, that is sigma v. It is the first type of plane. And second one is, we have passed a, it is a principal axis and we have passed the vertical plane of symmetry like this. Now for the oxygen atom, and second one is passing the plane of symmetry like this. That means here it is also parallel. It is a z axis. Here it is also parallel to the z axis. If here is, if you pass a vertical plane of symmetry, what happens means, here this oxygen will become like this and these two hydrogens will come like this. This is also imaginary plane is obtained. That means which are the mirror images of each other. So by passing the molecule, passing the vertical plane of symmetry for z axis like this once and like this once, like this and like this, you should imagine this. If you pass a imaginary plane like this, it cuts the molecule into first front and back. And if you pass a parallel axis of symmetry like this, it will cut a oxygen into like this, and this off will become the mirror image of this one. So here is the sigma v, and it is the second one, second vertical plane of symmetry. So how many vertical plane of symmetry are obtained? That is two sigma v's are obtained in the H2O molecule. And now let's take another example for this BF3. Here is the BF3. In the BF3, see, here it is the principal axis, it is the z axis. Okay, here is the z axis. Now here is the z axis. So if you pass a symmetry like this, vertical plane of symmetry like this, it is parallel to the z axis. Okay, it is cutting the B molecules and F molecules on this side, and this also B and F, and this molecule on this side. So it is, this is the mirror image of this second one. See, here we are passing a, it is a principal axis. So parallel to the principal axis, here it is a parallel to the principal axis. So we have done first two orbs. It is first one and it is second one. Next, see here, it is also parallel to the z axis. It is also parallel to the z axis. It is a z axis and it is also parallel to the z axis. See here, this is also offside and this is also off. These two are the mirror images of each other. See, if you pass an imaginary axis, that is vertical plane of symmetry like this, it is a z axis, it is also parallel to the z axis. So if you cut this, means this will become the mirror image of this one. That means here first off will become this one and second off will become this one. Here we have to pass the vertical plane in such a way that it is parallel to the principal axis. It is a principal axis, we are here passing the vertical plane of symmetry, and it is a principal axis, here we are passing the vertical plane of symmetry through one of the boron atom and also one of the F atoms, like this. How many number of sigma we have obtained here means, here is one of the sigma V and sigma V and the sigma V. There are total 3 sigma V in the BF3 molecule. Now let's take another example, that is NH3. There are 2 configurations for NH3. Let's take the configuration which is easy for you to understand. This is the configuration, one of the configuration of NH3. See, here is the hydrogens and it is C3 axis, and it is a principal axis, it is Z axis. It is a principal axis, it is a Z axis. It is also parallel. See, here it is a parallel axis. I have to draw it here. Parallel axis. Here we are passing a parallel axis. We will obtain a first off and it is the second off here. See, here it will become the mirror image of this one. It is cutting the N and H atom also, and these or one is a mirror image of the second one. This one is a mirror image of this second one. See here, let's take another time. In this, you can see here, if you pass here is a principal axis, no? If you pass parallel to the principal axis like this, vertical plane of symmetry, imaginary plane like this, it will also cut the molecule into 2 equal halves. This is the first one and it is the second one. It is a Z axis and we are passing a plane that is parallel. It is parallel like this. It is parallel to the Z axis and this is also cutting the molecule into 2 equal halves. And next again, this is the Z axis. No, if you pass a parallel axis again, parallel axis again, next, if you pass a parallel axis again, this off, this one will become first off and this one will become the second off. Exactly, it is cutting the nitrogen and hydrogen atom like this. It is a first off and it is a second off. So how many number of vertical plane of symmetry here? That is 3 sigma V. Here is 1 and these are the 2. There are total number of 3 sigma V in the NH3 molecule. Here is another vertical plane of symmetry. So it is sigma V, sigma V, sigma V. Total of 3 sigma V in the NH3 molecule. This completes the explanation of vertical plane of symmetry. The short trick for this plane of symmetry, if Cn is equals to n sigma V or 0 sigma V, that means if C3 is present means 3 sigma V will present or 0 sigma V present, and behind this nothing will be present. If C3 is present means there will be 3 sigma V or 0 sigma V. If C4 means 4 sigma V or 0 sigma V, like this. Based on the number of axes of symmetry, the vertical plane of symmetry may be present. That means they may be present in the n sigma V or 0 sigma V. What is horizontal plane of symmetry means? It is the imaginary plane. Imaginary plane that is perpendicular to the principal axis. It is perpendicular to the principal axis. Here, what is horizontal plane of symmetry means? It is an imaginary plane. It is perpendicular to the principal axis. Whereas vertical plane of symmetry means it is parallel to the principal axis. Now, we can see it by taking examples. See here, in the BF3 molecule, it is the BF3. In this BF3, see, it is the principal axis. It is the principal axis. And this surface is perpendicular to the principal axis. It is the principal axis. This is principal axis. And this plane is perpendicular to the principal axis. So, I am here placing this principal axis on this boron atom. See here, if it is a BF3 and it is the C3 axis. Here, it is the C3 axis of symmetry is present. It is a principal axis. And if the principal axis is here and it is perpendicular, the imaginary plane is passing like this and it will divide the molecule of BF3 like this. It is converted into two halves like this. This is the mirror image of this one and this is the plane. Here only one sigma H is present. Next, let's take another example. Let's take PtCl4 as an example. See here, it is a PtCl4. Cl. In this PtCl4, see here, here is the principal axis. It is a z axis. It is a principal axis. Here C4 axis of symmetry is present. Here the z axis. So we are passing the imaginary plane like this. This is perpendicular to the principal axis. This plane is perpendicular to the principal axis. As we seen in the BF3 molecule, if you consider it as a PtCl4 molecule, we are passing the principal axis here. The imaginary plane cuts the molecule like this. Back one and front one like this. PtCl4 is divided into like that. How many horizontal plane of symmetry is present in this PtCl4 means one horizontal plane of symmetry is present. In this vertical plane of symmetry also present. See here. Here is the principal axis. If you pass the parallel plane of symmetry, parallel plane here. So this off is a mirror image of this one. And if you pass the imaginary plane like this means this off is a mirror image of this one. And if you pass the mirror image like this, parallel to the principal axis, this off is mirror image to this one. And the other one is like this. If you pass the imaginary plane like this, this off will be mirror image of this one. Like that. This is in the PtCl4. Here is the C4 axis. We can directly write how many number of vertical plane of symmetry means. There are 4 sigma V. And 1 horizontal plane of symmetry. This is in the PtCl4. Now, let's see about the dihedral plane of symmetry. Now, the third type of plane of symmetry is, that is dihedral plane of symmetry. Third type is dihedral plane of symmetry. Yet, dihedral plane of symmetry will occur in staggered form and in the planar form. The dihedral plane of symmetry definition is different for these two, staggered and planar forms. First, let's see in the staggered form. Here in the staggered form, what happens means sigma V that bisects the angle between the two C2 axis is called dihedral plane of symmetry. Here the sigma V will bisect the angle between the two C2 axis, that is dihedral plane of symmetry in the staggered form. See, what is bisecting means, here if you consider these are the C2 axes. This is one C2 axis and this is another C2 axis. Here, if the sigma V is present, it is sigma V means This sigma v, which is bisecting the angle between, here is the angle between the C2 axes, two C2 axes. If the sigma v bisects the angle between the two C2 axes, then it is called as dihedral plane of symmetry. Here it is about the bisecting of the two C2 axes. These are the two C2 axes and this is the sigma v, that is vertical plane of symmetry, that is bisecting the angle between the two C2 axes, like this. Now let's study example of staggered ethane to study this. Ethane is having the general formula C2H6. This is C2H6. Now let's write the staggered ethane. Staggered ethane. Let's give the numbering H1, H2, H3 and H4, H5, H6. In this, this is the front carbon. This is the front carbon. It is a Newman projection. It is a front carbon and this circle is a back carbon. And these are the hydrogens. For this front carbon, hydrogens are H1, H2 and H3. For the back carbon, hydrogens are H4, H5 and H6. And I will also draw the salt structure of this to make you understand it better. See here. It is the staggered, salt structure of this. That is H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. See, compare these two. It is Newman and it is salt structure. Compare these two. It is a front carbon. So, here is a front carbon. This H1, H2 and H3. It is a back carbon and H4, H5, H6 like this. I have drawn it to make you understand. See here. Now let's draw the axis of, now let's imagine the axis of symmetry in this. If you pass the axis of symmetry like this, through this, it is the z axis, okay? It is the z axis. And if you rotate the molecule like this, this hydrogens will also rotate and these hydrogens will also rotate. You should imagine that if you are rotating this molecule like this, these three will also rotate and these three will also rotate. And here rotation is taken by 120 degree. If you rotate the molecule by 120 degree, we will get a equivalent configuration. That means C3 axis of symmetry is carried in this, that is 360 degree by 120. That means it n is equals to 3. C3 axis of symmetry. See here, if you rotate a molecule this by 120 degree, this H1 will come this side and this H2 will come this side and this H3 will go that side. And if you carry out this operation by C3 axis, then we will get a identical configuration. Now here also, if you these are rotating, means these will also will rotate. This H5 will come in the position of H4, H4 will come here and this H6 will come here if you rotate the molecule by 120 degree. If you rotate the molecule by 120 degree, we will get a version configuration. Here if you rotate this by C3 axis, these two are same structures, but this is Newman projection and it is Sauer's projection. If you rotate the molecule by C3 axis, and we will get a equivalent configuration. Here also H1 will come in the position of H2, H2 will come in the position of H3 by rotating 120 degree, and by C3 operations we will get a equivalent configuration. Now C3 is the principal axis. Now we have to see secondary axes. That means we need C2 axes. So I will once again draw this Newman projection. please listen it carefully. This is H1, H2 and H3, whereas we have named it as H4, H5 and H6. See here, in this C2 axis is here. See, here if we pass the axis like this and rotate a molecule, if you rotate a molecule, what happens means, if you rotate a molecule, this H1 will come in the position of H4, okay? We are rotating a molecule. So this H1 will come in the position of H4 and this H4 will come in the position of H1. And this H3 will come in the position of H6 and this H6 will come in the position of H3. And this H5 will go in the position of H2 and H2 will come in the position of H5. That means, see here the C2, let's name it as the first C2, that is 1 C2. In the 1 C2, what is happening? That is H1 is coming in the position of H4 and H4 is coming in the position of H1 and H2 is coming in the position of H5 and H3 in the position of H6. And again we will draw another C2 axis of symmetry in this. See, another C2 of axis is present here. Like this. C3 is the principal axis. These are the secondary axes present in the molecule. And in the two C2 axis, what happens means, this H4 will come in the position of H2 and H2 will go in the position of H4. And again, H5, H3 and H1, H6. See, H5, H3. These will go in the position of this one by rotating. By rotating a molecule, this will come in the position of this one and this H1 will come in the position of H6 and H6 will become in the position of H1. It is about the 2C2. Here rotating and this H4 will come in the position of H2, like that. And again, another C2 axis is present. Here, if you pass it like this, C2 axis is present. If you rotate the molecule, what happens means, this H5 will come in the position of H1 and this H2 will come in the position of H6 and H6 will go there and this will go here and this will come here and this will come here and this will go here. This H4 will come in the position of H3 and H3 will come in the position of H4. Now let's write them. That is H1, H5, H2, H6, H4, H3. It is, let's 3C2. It is 3C2. Now see here. Here is a vertical plane of symmetry that is passing here. It is a vertical plane of symmetry. That means it is parallel to the principal axis. Here the principal axis and the vertical plane of symmetry. I will write here sigma v, vertical plane of symmetry. According to definition, sigma v should bisect the two C2 axes. It is the sigma v. Here it is a principal axis here, and parallel to this sigma v is present. It cuts the molecule into two equal halves. And this sigma v is bisecting the angle between the two C2 axes. See here, here is one of the C2 axis and here is one of the C2 axis. This sigma v is bisecting the angle between these two C2 axes. See here, here one of the C2 is present and here is the C2 is present. And this sigma v is bisecting the angle between the two C2 axes like this. Here is the C2, here is the C2 and this sigma v is bisecting the angle between the two C2 axes. So, here the dihedral plane of symmetry is present. Here is the dihedral plane of symmetry present like this. Here is the angle. And another, look here. Here is also a vertical plane of symmetry here. Vertical plane of symmetry present here. Okay, here is also a vertical plane of symmetry. Here, this off is like this and this off is like that. And here is the sigma v. It is a principal axis and parallel to this I have drawn a sigma v. and it cuts the molecule into two equal halves. One is a mirror image of the other. Here also you can see, here is a sigma V and it is bisecting this one. See here, these are the two C2 axes. Here what happened is, here these are the two C2 axes present like this and the sigma V is present like this. See here is the sigma V and here are the one C2 axis and here the second C2 axis. For the third C2, another dihedral plane of symmetry is present. See here in the H5 and H2. In the H5 and H2. H5 and H2. This H5 and H2 is the sigma V. That means this off is the mirror image of this one and it is parallel to the principal axis. Here is the principal axis and this is the sigma V plane and this is the mirror image of this one. See here, these are the two C2 axes between these. Here is the sigma V. That means these are two C2 axes like this and this sigma V is like this. That means how many dihedral plane of symmetry is present means, that is 3 dihedral plane of symmetry is present. I think this picture has become some clumsy. So I will draw it once again to make you understand it. See here, I will draw only one of the dihedral plane of symmetry. This is H1, H2 and H3. And this is H4, H5 and H6. And these are the two C2 axes. These are the two C2 axes. One C2 axis is like this. And this is the another C2 axis. Here it is the vertical plane of symmetry. That means it is making the mirror image of this one, vertical plane of symmetry. Here what should happen? Vertical plane of symmetry should bisect two C2 axes like this. Here is the sigma means this C2 axis. So here is the sigma V. Here are the two C2 axes. See here. So it is a dihedral plane of symmetry. Let's represent the plane like this. Like this, 3 dihedral plane of symmetry is present in the this staggered ethane. This sigma V here called as sigma D. Make it corrected. This sigma V here is called as sigma D here. Now let's study in the planar molecules. In planar molecules and pyramidal molecules, not only planar molecules, in the planar and pyramidal molecules also, pyramidal molecules, the definition is the sigma V that passes through the less number of atoms is called as sigma D. In the planar molecules or pyramidal molecules, sigma V that passes through the less number of atoms is called as a sigma D. That is, sigma V passes through the less number of atoms is called as sigma D. See here, consider PtCl4. This Pt and Cl4, PtCl4. In this sigma V, let's see what are the sigma V's here. See, here is the one of the sigma V, vertical plane of symmetry. Is one of the sigma V. That means it divides the molecule into two equal halves and it is plane is perpendicular to the parallel to the principal axis. It is principal axis and this plane is perpendicular parallel to the principal axis. It is sigma V. It is a first off and it is second off. These are two are the mirror images of each other. If you pass an imaginary plane like this and it is also parallel to this is also parallel to principal axis, so it is sigma v. It also divides the molecule into two equal halves, and another plane is passing through here. See here, it is a principal axis, parallel to it we are drawing a imaginary axis, that is sigma v, that is dividing the molecule into two equal halves, that is one is a mirror image of the other one. And again we can pass the imaginary plane like this, and it is a principal axis, it is parallel line, and this is the sigma v, and this is the mirror image of this one, like that. Here what happens means, when this sigma v passes through the less number of atoms, here it is called as sigma d. In this, see here, sigma v is passing here, sigma is passing through the, here is a sigma v, it is passing through the three atoms, okay. Here 1, 2, 3 atoms, and here also how many atoms? Here sigma v is passing through only one atom, and this sigma v is also passing through only one atom. So these two number of atoms is less, that means here are three, but here the sigma v is passing through only one atom, it is the sigma d. Here this is no more called sigma v, it is called as sigma d. Now it is also no more called a sigma v here, it is also called sigma d here. If it passes through the less number of atoms, then it is called as sigma d. So in the PTCl4 there are 4 sigma v's. No, in the 4 sigma v's, 2 sigma v's are present, but 2 dihedral plane of symmetry and 2 axis of symmetry among 4 vertical plane of symmetry. 2 vertical planes are symmetry of present, and 2 dihedral plane of symmetry are present. Once again I will explain it. It is a PTCl4 molecule. Here we should first check the sigma v in the planar molecules. We have seen already in the staggered molecules, now we are seeing in the planar molecules. Here we have to check the sigma v. If you check the sigma v here, what is sigma v means? It is vertical plane of symmetry, it is parallel to the principal axis. Here is the principal axis and it is parallel to the principal axis. We have to draw imaginary line that should bisect the molecule in such a way that one half is a mirror image of the other. So we have obtained 4 sigma v's here, but here this sigma v is passing through 3 atoms, and this sigma v is passing through 3 atoms, where this 3 sigma v is passing through only 1 atom, and this sigma v is also passing through only 1 atom. So this sigma v's are no more called sigma v, they are called as sigma d. So among 4 sigma v's, there are only 2 sigma v's and 2 sigma d's are present. Sigma d means dihedral plane of symmetry. Sigma v means vertical plane of symmetry. You may think in the BF3 molecule. See, to explain this, we can take BF3 molecule as example. It is F1, F2, F3. In the F1, F2, F3, this BF3, what happens means, here is a vertical plane of symmetry. It is sigma v, and here is a sigma v, and here is also a sigma v, that is dividing the molecules into two equal halves. But see here, this sigma v is passing to two atoms, and this sigma v is also passing through two atoms, and this sigma v is also passing through two atoms. So all the atoms are present, so it is not called as dihedral plane of symmetry, it is only called as sigma v. But when the sigma v is called as a dihedral plane of symmetry, means it should pass through less number of atoms, then it will called as dihedral plane of symmetry. But in the BF3, it is all the vertical planes are passing through two atoms only, so it is not called as dihedral plane of symmetry. Whereas in the PTCl4, two are passing through one atom, so it is called as dihedral plane of symmetry. This is the total explanation of about the plane of symmetry and its types, that is vertical plane of symmetry, horizontal plane of symmetry and dihedral plane of symmetry. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.